You are watching Skyrim commentary from Shauna Films.
My mill here. My father's gone. We don't know what happened to him.
When I first installed RS Children, I thought, oh, this is the bee's knees. Each kid is different, unique, all that kind of stuff. Way better than the vanilla kids. And now, you know, years later, you know, I recently reinstalled RS Children, and I'm looking at the faces of these kids, and I'm thinking, oh man, this is a ripoff. Every kid looks exactly the same. I mean, all the boys have the same exact face. They just have a different hairstyle, and they call them a different kid. Such a ripoff. And now that I think about it, The Kids Are Alright does the same thing.
Get an axe and bring me all the wood you can chop.
No, it can't be. Oh my. And all this time I was thinking he'd been unfaithful to me. I feel so stupid.
I've been a fool, wasting my time sitting here helpless when I could have sent help sooner. Perhaps this is all my doing. What's done is done. Here, I want you to have this. Bringing me closure was kind of you. Be careful and stay safe.
Mother, I finished cutting at the north.
Yeah, the kids are all right. It does the same thing.
There's a Cups of Elms to the east. We could
really the boys in that mod pretty much all look identical. Once in a while you see a boy with a different haircut. That's it.
Just be careful, Grolnak. That Cups doesn't look safe. If you see any trouble, you run right home.
I'm guessing kids have one of those face geom files that include the NIF and the eyeballs, and I bet if I look at the NIF files for each of those kids, it's just the same kid. It's the same NIF, same mesh. No unique NIF for a kid's face. I like how the guy that made the goblin mod, I like that he's got them scripted to not attack me during this one scene here. They're factioned with the orcs. Because normally the goblins will kill me on sight.
Would you have me disobey him? You were charged with keeping us inside the walls. Have faith.
Because that would be irritating if she's telling you about the troll fat and the Daedra heart and all that.
Forgive Ugo.
While you're being attacked by her goblin neighbors. She's been told.
No, don't go. Please, our tribe suffers, and we need help. Our chief Yamarz was once a strong and proud warrior. Now he is stricken, cursed. He is weak, and so our tribe is weak. The giants sense this and intrude on our territory. Now they assault our very home. Yamarz refuses help, but I sense that you may be just what we need. Yamarz has demanded we stay inside the walls. We cannot leave. I must petition Malakath for relief.
I am very tempted to install immersive armors.
The ritual must be done here.
Because I like the outfit that the witch doctors all wore with that mod installed.
Troll fat and a Daedra heart. I have no wish to depend on a stranger, but I have no choice.
Because the black hooded robe is kind of boring. Let's face it.
Please hurry. We are counting on you.
We have sworn loyalty to Yamarz. He will see us through these dark times.
Are you farming?
By the ash pit. We can't go on like this.
Don't remember ever seeing an orc do that before.
We won't kill you, Outlander. But we don't want you here.
Oh, that's rude. I think she becomes a follower later on, or it might be another. Might be another female orc that you can make a follower. Well, one of the guys, he can be a follower. So the thing is, sometimes these NPCs will die here because the giants keep attacking. The longer you lollygag with this quest, the more likely that, you know, future companions won't be around in Skyrim because they've been killed off by the giant attacks. Kind of cool, but kind of annoying if you don't want anyone to die in your game.
Before I let you into Riften, you need to pay the visitor's tax. For the privilege of entering the city. What does it matter?
So I ripped out the magic card main font that I was using.
Want everyone to hear you?
Which was the Morrowind. The Morrowind true type font. Ripped it out because I got tired of not being able to read the teeny tiny print.
You can head inside when you're ready.
I'd see these notifications in the corner of my screen. I couldn't read any of them. And they're not there for very long to read.
Please. Call upon me if I can be of any service.
So this is the boring vanilla font that comes with Skyrim. Hopefully I can read things like how many lockpicks I have left, the enchantments on various weapons and rings that I'm wearing, the effects of potions that I'm making.
I can't just ignore them, Eren.
I know. I just don't want you to leave. You're the only good thing that's happened.
It's weird. How come I can't?
I don't know you. You and Riften looking for trouble? That's the wrong.
I can't open
answer.
A barrel when I first get here. I thought I could.
Around here is some troublemaker trying to steal a piece of the action.
Could be a reputation thing.
You can pretend not to hear me all you want.
Nobody knows me in this game. I'm still an unknown as far as reputation goes.
I'm really getting tired of your excuses. When you borrowed the money, you said you'd pay it back on time and for double the usual fee.
I know I did, but how was I to know the shipment would get robbed?
Next time, keep your plans quieter, and nothing would have happened to you.
If you viewers at home notice anything different about the dialogues, dialogue choices in my dialogue boxes,
all I care about is the gold.
It's probably because of one of the two mods I have installed that makes edits to NPC dialogue, and there's more edits, and then there's the other one. Anyway, so it rephrases questions so they make more sense, and there might be more choices to
Haven't
select
you
from.
Got some chores to do? Sure, whatever.
It could. Now that I think about it, it's because I'm super attractive. Everyone hates me because I'm super attractive. And that's probably why I can't open a frickin' barrel to scrounge for things.
Need something? Oh, thank you. Divines bless your kind heart.
And I want to put... what's it called?
Skyrim. Tell them to head to Windhelm. Ulfric Stormcloak wants to see them.
Got some Stormcloaks here? That's neat. What's that mod called with the torches? Real torches? It's either called real torches or immersive torches. But I'm out of ESP slots. It's the mod that, you'll have a torch with you, and as soon as it rains, the torch goes out. If you swim, the torch goes out. If there's a blizzard going on, or if it's super windy, the torch blows out.
Need something?
Until next time.
The finest skooma.
And you can make your own torches. If you got the firewood and the other thing and the other thing. But for now, I'm using a default torch.
Nice doing business with you, friend.
And I have something, I think it's called improved torches. So the light coming from my torch is more natural looking instead of flashlight looking. Because the default light from the torch looks like you're holding a flashlight instead of a flame. And I remember years ago, literally years ago, my carriage drivers all had lanterns. And I don't know what mod that was, and I've never been able to get those to come back. No matter what mods I install. But I always thought that was kind of neat. Maybe it was lamps. What was it, street lamps of Skyrim? That did that? Because it's been a while since I used that mod when it first came out. And I haven't used it since because it doesn't make sense to have street lamps down the roads. Like, who's going around lighting the candles every day to keep those street lamps lit?
What do you want? I owe a great deal of money to someone, and I think they cheated me. I don't know what to do. I was able to work out a deal with the stables in Whiterun to sell me some of their tack and harness.
Hey, why did I do this at night when you can't see anything?
To pay for the shipment, but it got robbed before
I'm just now realizing that now there's nothing to see in this video.
If I don't pay her, I think she's going to kill me.
You will? And people on their phones
thank you.
Watching these videos, if no one watches.
Be careful with Sapphire.
Now, let's be honest, no one watches my videos anymore because they're on phones. None of my friends have computers, they have phones. No one wants to rack up minutes on their phone watching my YouTube videos. But if they did, if they chose to, they would have a nice black widescreen image to look at because, you know, when you're on your phone watching a video, you tend to be in a bright room somewhere with headlamps above you reflecting off your phone screen. Makes watching Driscoll videos very challenging. Me, I'm on a computer at home in a darkened room. The only light in my room 99% of the time is coming from my monitor.
The return of the dragons is not mere coincidence. This is one of the signs. The signs that Lady Mara is displeased with your constant inebriation. Put down your flagons filled with your...
Who's that guy? Oh, that's the...
And embrace the teachings of the handmaiden.
That's him. I was looking for him.
No, Marumal.
I want to make sure he's immortal in my game.
Kirava, certainly.
I think if it is the guy.
Understanding.
Let me check. Was it the guy?
Must be made aware
yep,
of
it was the guy, the prostitute.
Enough, Marumal.
That comes with Riften if you include mods like I do.
To harass our customers. Very well, Talon.
I don't like it when prostitutes are murdered in my game for some reason. I don't know why.
We're not kicking you out.
It's like I put the effort into putting prostitutes of Skyrim in my game and then patching them to get them to work with other mods. And I didn't want to do all that work just to have them die in fight scenes in the cities or dragon attacks or bandit attacks. So I'm trying to...
I'm saying you've got the coin, but you
I'm just making...
accept him of it honestly.
I'm making the guy essential while Brynjol shows up, force greets me.
Oh, but that's where you're wrong, lass. Wealth is my business. Maybe you'd like a taste. I've got a bit of an errand to perform, but I need...
In my mind, I'm thinking there's only five or six
line of work,
prostitutes added to the game. No, there's way more than that. It's like,
simple.
Oh, wow.
I'm going to cause
it's gotta be 12 or 13
you're
of them.
Gonna steal Medesi's silver
maybe 15
strongbox
of them.
Under a stand.
Because it makes some NPCs in the game into... It turns some of them into prostitutes also.
Oh, sorry. I usually have a nose for this kind of thing. Never mind then, lass. If you change your mind, come find me.
So who's with me? Who is that Uthgard over there? Who's dressed up like me? I think it is. Looks like Uthgard.
You lost?
So something else I've been doing is ripping out the beast skeletons.
If you've got the coin, you're welcome here. Otherwise,
and ripping off their feet.
Sure thing. It's yours for a day.
Their beast feet.
I'll show you to your room right this way.
So I think this is where I saw purple ankles, and that drives me nuts when I see purple ankles. Because I've got UMP clothing installed, armor installed, blah blah blah, and yeah, she's got purple ankles. That just drives me nuts. So,
I presume you're bothering me for a good reason.
I'm gonna give all the beasts back their vanilla legs and feet. And walking, walk cycles back and run cycles back. So they'll look like dudes and dudettes from afar, but once you get close, you realize, oh my goodness, this person has a cat head. This person has a lizard head. Because the way they stand, their legs are more beast-like when they're standing up. So you can tell the difference between a beast in a humanoid kind of thing from a distance. Huh? But then I thought, you know what? I need an ESP. I need an ESP, so that one's gonna go. Because I want to put back some werewolf mods and some vampire mods that I ripped out to make use of Sacrosanct and Growl. And I decided not to use Growl and not to use Sacrosanct. I'm just gonna try my best to roleplay using vanilla werewolf and vanilla vampires.
All hail to Ulfric, you are the High King.
And if I really can't stand the two, I'll put Growl and Sacrosanct back in, but only if those mods are made more friendly, more compatible with what I got installed right now. There's a mod called Moonlight Tales. I've never tried it. There's one called Better Vampires. I've never tried that one. Never, ever, ever. Maybe. If they're not too hard to patch to make work with my game, I might give those a try.
Our hero claims a warrior's heart. I tell you.
I might get rid of some adopted kids that I'll probably never adopt to make room for more ESP slots.